any time scales for getting the deal done between Kell Brook and Amir Khan?
Whenever Amir decides what he wants to do. Totally in his hands, probably 7 days. I felt like this morning he will probably fight Crawford. But after Kell's performance, maybe he fancies that. I mean, I would say he's the favourite to win after that performance. But we shall see. The clock is ticking.
And how much money is on the table for that fight for both fighters?
Enough to buy a small island.
Go on, tell us numbers. Go on.
Don't be ridiculous.
Go on, ballpark.
20 million Japanese yen. There we go. Right,
there we go.
Hey, Joe Howe, boxing voice, Eddie. Just a quick one on Amir Khan, Kell Brook again. If it's not going to happen, what's the next realistic fight for Kell Brook?
Well, it's mandatory to Jarrett Hurd. It's a very tough fight. We have Jesse Vargas in the States. I think that's a good fight. Sean Porter rematch is a great fight. Danny Garcia, Keith Thurman, any of those guys he'd take. But that's why I'm saying it's now or never for Brook Khan, because if Khan's fighting Crawford and Brook's fighting Hurd and these kind of levels, someone's going to lose. And then as soon as someone loses, it's all over.
Asad Malik from Behind the Gloves. Eddie, if Amir Khan, you have made it quite clear that if Amir Khan doesn't fight Brook, makes this fight, it's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. If Amir Khan decides to play roulette and does go ahead with the Crawford, is it 100% certainty that Brook fight is not going to happen?
Because Brook will fight someone else. And then, you know, we also have, with Amir, his scheduling is, you know, he wants to get, obviously gets his fight in before Ramadan, and then we'll look to box maybe on the back end of the year. So I think he really wants to box April time, something like that, April, May. And Kell will jump in a big fight. Someone will get beat. And then negotiations are just completely different again. Someone's like, if Khan beats Crawford and Kell loses, Amir's going to want 90-10. And if Kell beats Jarrett Hurd or Sean Porter and Kell, Amir loses, Kell's going to want 70-30. And then it's just all bollocks. It's like, we're in the same problem. At the moment, Amir's got the lion's share. He's got the weight he wants. He's got the rehydration clause, which, by the way, wasn't even discussed with Kell yet. And he's just told us he'll do it, which is a massive advantage for Amir Khan. Now's the time.
Who's a front runner for Anthony Joshua's next fight?
If we had a choice, Deontay Wilder. If we can't get Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury. If we can't get Tyson Fury, Dillian White, if he beats Chisora in a couple of weeks. Usyk, Jarrell Miller, like all these guys, they'll come in time. But AJ wants to be undisputed, and the only way he can do that is to fight Wilder.
Has there been any talks of Usyk at all?
Absolutely none at all.
Nothing at all?
I heard it's been announced, apparently, but it's not. We have not even had one conversation about it. No.
It's going on a small head movement TV, Adam Martell as well. Do you think the change of trainer for Brook could have contributed to...
Probably, yeah. But not as in it's a bad move. Mm-hmm. Just when you change trainers and you change styles, you can't expect just to gel into a fight and look better than you did last time. So I expect him to be a lot better next time than he was tonight. But, you know, I thought he's a bit overcritical. I mean, I thought he boxed really well for the first three or four rounds, then just went flat. Got a little tired, got
Zarafa
a bit frustrated. Zarafa was sort of like borderline surviving and then pop shotting. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, great chin. And he got hit by a lot, but Kell wasn't punching as crisply as he has done in the past. And, you know, I thought in the first round it would be over. Like, if you would have said at the end of the first round, do you think this will go out of points? Not one person in the arena would have said yes.
Ben Fricky, Boxing News TV. Eddie, this was the final eliminator for Jarrett Hurd's WBA title, but there was no mention of him in the post-fight presser. Kell didn't mention him at all. How serious are you about pursuing that if you can't make Khan?
I just think he's got it in his head at the moment to go to welterweight. So, listen, he's in a great position whereby he's a mandatory for Jarrett Hurd, but I think he wants to explore the options at 147 as well. But it's a great fallback option. I mean, a lot of the guys that are tagged up, aren't they? You know, you've got Sean Porter's got a fight scheduled. Danny Garcia's got a fight scheduled. Keith Thurman's got a fight scheduled. Jesse Vargas is a fight we can do for Kell Brook in March or April. And so is Jarrett Hurd, because it will go to purse bids. And that would be great to have a bid on.
You came in at 150. Do you think there was a conscious decision to do that, just to show that you can come?
Kell's problem of making 147 is just ballooning between fights. That's it. Yeah. So, and the reason I said he can't do welterweight anymore is because of what he does between fights. He eats far too much. He'll have a drink and then he'll be 13 and a half stone. And he's got to lose 3 stone in the camp. And the whole camp, you know, and I feel frustrated for Dominic Ingle, because the whole camp has always been about making the weight. You know, for this fight, you saw his face on the scales. You couldn't even see his cheekbones. Normally, he looks, I mean, on the Errol Spence weigh-in, he was fucked. completely fucked. So all he had to do was three more pounds. It's an advantage for Amir, I still believe, at 147, and especially with the rehydration, because he used to have to sometimes make weight when he boxed Sean Porter. No one knows that. He took £4 off on the day of that fight in America. You're allowed to do it in America. You're not allowed to do it in the UK on the day of the fight. You know? Just to make the weight against Sean Porter and still boxed his ear holes off.
Thank you for boxing, so sure. Eddie, I know you've got to shoot some quick couple of questions.